Praise the Lord. God is busy. He's busy with His church. He's busy with the miracle in your life. He's busy with your pastor. So watch this space. As the Here die pastoor kan werk, kan die kerk ook daar as jy gaan nie. Watch this space. This week I had a small incident. My back went out to a point where I couldn't even walk. And I said, Lord, 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 please, not again. Last time it took me 6 months to come right. And I hobbled back home and hoe is a crutch, and my wife prayed for me and Liesel prayed for me and some people prayed for me, and the worst of it only lasted a day. And thank you Jesus for divine healing and the grace that's upon that God that we have got through Jesus Christ. There's lots happening. I was hoping to have the toilets fixed, the new toilets ready. The hospice at my office. It's a good place to do admin. But hopefully by next Sunday the toilets will be fixed, so you don't have to have a 4x4 to get to the other toilets. Praise God for some donations. One of the kids gave us a donation for a septic tank. You know, it's a miracle, and we've got donations for new toilets, and thanks for those who gave the donations that don't want to be mentioned. So, yeah, the next project will be the Saja. That's going to be the prayer room. So I think we're going to start with the prayer room, then Sunday school, then bright place, then kitchen. I think maybe we'll start with kitchen, I don't know. But I think let's start with the prayer room, we'll see. So we depend on donations, Build It. We've been buying the best prices for building blocks, comes from Build It. That's what we built most of the church, so if people feel like giving donations. I have to testify this morning that 90% of this church has been built not from church funds.
Amen.
From donations, okay? So, cement and building blocks. If the Lord works in your heart to donate some cement and building blocks, do that. Okay? And if the Lord, if you don't have money for building blocks, just pray for somebody that the Lord will make them obedient. Okay, amen. It's nice, lovely to serve the Lord, amen. He's my King, He's my Lord, He's my Savior, and His name is Jesus. En ek dank die Here dat hy my siel gered het. Ek weet, hy mannetjie raak het aan die gerrie. Los die mannetjie uit gerrie. Hy pla my nie. En ek bly om te hoor van die getuienisse wat uitkom. En ek kan vir die boere sê, die mens wat werkers sê, as iemand vir jou sê, sy tannie is siek, gaan bid vir hom. En hy gaan so bang wees om te lieg daaruit. Ewe skielik gaan niemand wil sê ouma siekie, want die baas gaan kom bid vir my ouma. So kom die dinge vinnig in die lig. En ek dink as jy vir jou werker gaan bid by sy huis, as jy vir jou werker sy familie gaan bid by sy huis, sal die werker loyaal wees teenoor jou soos nog nooit van tevore nie. Dit wys jou dat jy nie hypocrite is nie. En wys jou dat jy regtig geloof het, en wys jou dat jy omgee. As ek kyk na die, if I look at the story of the Roman centurion that seek Jesus for his servant that was sick. So let's do that. Let's do that for our servants as well, for those who have servants. Right now, this morning, you know, the big issue about faith. Often you come to church, and you see these people in church and you wish, wow, I wish I had that kind of faith. But I can tell you something, some people are looking at you and also thinking by themselves, I wish I had that kind of faith. Now we all have some measure of faith. I believe Jesus is the Son of God. I believe that God created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, and the seventh day he rested. Some people want to make it 6,000 days. I believe it was 6 days. It was the evening, and it was morning, and it was the next day. Time doesn't matter to God. He's a miracle-working God. I believe that God saved my soul. And that was the most difficult thing to believe originally. You know, when you were not saved, you completely believed how saved you were. Amen. And the day you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and the day you received the Holy Spirit, then all of a sudden the devil tries to convince you how not saved you are. So when you're not saved, when you're saved, when you're not saved, the devil tells you how saved you are. And the day you get saved, you start doubting your salvation. And we need to believe in our salvation. We need to believe that we are justified through Christ Jesus. We need to believe in the blood of Jesus Christ. We need to believe in the Word of God. And sometimes that kind of faith takes a bit of a dip. And this morning I'm going to speak about faith. Blaai dan na Markus 9 toe. Vers 17. Wat gebeur hierso? Dat 'n pa het 'n kind wat hy sê maansiek was, amper soos epilepsie. En wat gebeur is, hy's lief vir die kind, hy gee om vir die kind. En die kind kry styf trek en dan val hy in die vuur. Dan moet hy nou die vuur uithelp en dan val hy in die water. En hy huil oor sy kind wat siek is. En ek dink vandag, as ek kyk na die kind van die Here, en ek kyk na God die Vader, en ek kyk na die kerk, baie keer, as ons weer kyk, dan val sy kinders in die vuur, en dan val sy kinders in die water. Baie keer voel het, jy staan sterk, en jy dien die Here, en jy loop op pad, as jy weer, dan val jy die kant toe, en as jy val die kant toe, en jy vraag, Here, help my. Ek sit hier om sterk te staan, ek het besluit, ek gaan ophou rook, ek het geglo, ek gaan ophou rook, en ek het opgehou rook, en toe die stress my weer tref, toe rook ek weer. Wie van jy, amen. Die koninkryk van God is nie te rook of nie te rookie. Okay. It's all about trying. Sometimes you need a lot of faith to deal with some habit in your life. And you feel like that way. And I think this morning, Jesus wants to take his sons and his daughters to the Father and says, I have this son. I have this daughter. Let's try hard. But sometimes she falls in the fire and sometimes she falls in the water. Couple of years ago, many years ago, I was visiting a friend and they were busy building a lodge. And Keenan was yay big. And I walked up to the top of the lodge, and you know, these kids are around you. And next thing I hear, where? Where? And I look down from the lodge and there he's in the swimming pool. As it turns, where? He's calling Daddy. And he goes, head below the water. Where? Daddy, head below the water. Now water is a big killer of children. I've never moved so fast in my life to save that boy. And if this morning you feel like I'm battling to survive, expect a miracle. Just say to God the Father, I'm in trouble, I'm suffering. I'm suffering, I need help. So this is what's playing off here. And, as I get myself here crying, so verse 17, I say, the ene die skare antwoord en sê, meester, ek het 'n seun wat 'n stomme gees het na u gebring. En waar hy kom, waar hy hom ook al aangryp, skeer hy hom. En hy kry skuim in sy mond. En hy knerg op sy tande. En hy word styf. En ek het die disippels gevra om hom uit te dryf. En hulle kon nie. En ek het die disippels gevra om hom uit te dryf. En hulle kon nie. Now, who of you has had that feeling, knowing that you're a child of God, knowing that you're anointed of God, knowing that there's a calling upon your life, knowing that God called you to lay hands upon sick, and people come to you and say, please pray for me, and you do not have the kind of faith you need to deal with that situation. Then you feel so sorry, why didn't I prepare myself? Why didn't I pray more? There's a situation here. And I think it was quite embarrassing for the disciples. The other disciples, the pressure was off. It was for the vernedering and verleentheid. For hulself, miskien hulle eie ego, miskien nog vir die koninkryk van God. Jesus, ek het die pastoor gevra om by te bid en ek is nog siek. Jesus, ek het die selleier gevra om by huwelik te bid. Maar my huwelik val nog steeds in mekaar uit. Die uitdaging van wie ons sit as kinders van die Here. Die uitdaging wat ons sit met die beroeping en die roeping wat op ons lewens het om die koninkryk van God te bevorder. Lewe jou self met die mense se lewens in. Dit sê hulle kon nie. En toe antwoord hy hom en sê, "Moe ongelowige geslag, hoe lang sal ek by julle wees? Hoe lang sal ek julle verdra? Bring hom na my toe." En hulle bring hom toe. En toe hy hom sien, laat die gees om dadelik stuiptrekkers kry en hy val op die grond neer en rol met hom met skuim in sy mond. Daarom vra sy vader, "Hoe lank is dit dat al hoe lank is dit al dat hom oorgekom het?" En hy sê, "Van kinds daar af." Dikwels het hy homself in die vuur en in die water gegooi om hom dood te maak. "Maar as u iets kan doen, ontferm u tog oor ons en help ons." En Jesus sê vir hom, "Wat dit betref, as jy kan glo, alle dinge is moontlik vir die een wat glo." Nou kyk hier so waarmee sit hierdie pa nou te doen. Jesus sê vir hom, as jy kan glo, is dit moontlik. Die partytjie sit met so soveel van die feite van die saak. The fact of the matter is a problem. Once there was a young man, it was a serious car accident, and on the WhatsApp, all the facts of the matter came through. All the facts of the matter, how bad the damage is, how bad the accident is, how he's busy dying, how incurable it is, and how this and how all the facts of the matter is coming through. Okay, so you sit with all the facts. Next thing somebody phones me and says, "Sean, won't you come with us to go pray for this young man?" So I was sitting there with all the facts of the matter in my mind, knowing that this young man is going to die. It's a problem. Now knowing that this young man is going to die, somebody phones me and asks me, "Won't I come pray for him?" Jy moet die pastoor. Jy moet geloof hê. Amen. No problem. Take it to the pastor. And I get into the car and I start driving and I pick some other brothers up, not believing that God is going to heal this man. Has it happened to you? Oh, please say yes. Say amen. Not believing that God's going to heal this man. And I said, "Lord," if you look at the next part of the scripture, what he says, "Lord," verse 24, "and immediately the father of the child cried out and said in tears, 'Lord, I believe, help my unbelief.'" He says, "I believe a bit, but there's still a lot of unbelief. I believe you can, but help me with my unbelief." And I said, "Lord, help me. I cannot go and pray for somebody that you will save their lives if I believe that they're going to die." And I started praying. And I started praying. I picked up my brothers. And we started having fellowship. We started speaking on the word of God. We started speaking. We praat oor die grootheid van die Here. Ja, by daai hospitaal stop te glo ek God gaan daai kind red. Amen. Ja, klap tog iemand in die hande. Jy pas hoor dat 'n bietjie geloof het. When I got to that hospital, I believed that child will live. I looked at the family and I saw unbelief in their eyes. And I started preaching the word of God to the family and friends. And after we laid a hand on that boy, I could see the people's eyes, there's faith. There's faith. 6 months or 7 months later, he was back in university. The doctor said there'll be a cabbage for life. So there comes a time, like the father, we say, "I believe a little bit, but there's still a lot of unbelief. Lord, help my unbelief." And sometimes we are too embarrassed to speak it to the Lord about our unbelief. We start ons op ons brein as vir die Here praat. "Dankie vir my kos, dankie vir my klere, dankie dat jy vir ons kyk, dankie dat jy vir ons..." Maar ons wil nie vir dat die Here toe kom met ons swakheid nie. Vandag wil ons net 'n bietjie dink aan geloof. Ek wil julle aandag rig op geloof. Hoe gaan ons as die bruid van Christus? And I don't want to use the word the church, otherwise I think it's this church. How are we as a bride of Christ going to get the kind of faith that God needs to make a difference in this world? How are we going to get there? And I want to help you. And I want to help myself. I want God to help us. So I can be the pastor that I need to be. And that you can be the saint that you need to be. Because God says my job as a pastor is to equip the saints for the service of God. And it all starts with faith. Geloof. Dan gaan ons bietjie verder. Hoe lyk hulle my slides op? I'm getting there. Kan nie maklik nie. Let's go to Hebrew 11 verse 1. We've quoted this one. Wat is geloof? Hy sê, die geloof dan is 'n vaste vertroue op die dinge wat ons hoop, 'n bewys van die dinge wat ons nie sien. Want daardeur het die mense van die ou tyd getuienis ontvang. Die geloof verstaan ons dat die wêreld deur die woord van God toeberei is, sodat die dinge wat gesien word nie ontstaan het uit sienlike dinge nie. That before you can have faith in anything, before you can start thinking about faith, you have to believe that the word of God is the word of God. That everything was created through the word of God. And you have to have unwavering faith in the word of God. Okay, ons begin hierso. Baie mense bedwaal hier en begin by die woord van God. Die Bybel sê, dan sê hulle eintlik, if somebody says the original translations means the opposite, you know, they're from the devil. In the real Arabic, it actually means the opposite. Have you spoken to those 7 days after this? They always say the original text actually means the opposite. Somebody gets there, and then once they're finished with that, the Church of Jesus Christ of the Latter-day Saints, they start with the Bible, and the fact that you believe in the Bible, they take you to a doctrine, and they tell you the Bible doesn't exist. So why did they start with the Bible? Krishna. I had an incident with the Krishnas once. That was quite fun. The Krishna starts off an argument with the word of God, saying that Jesus went to India and became a Krishna. So they believe in Jesus, because the Bible speaks of Jesus, but then next thing they throw the Bible away, they want to hang on to Krishna. So when people start with these kind of things, it brings confusion. You need to believe that this word is the word of God and the world existed through the word of God. Amen. Okay. So just hang in there. The word of God will manifest itself. Sometimes not immediately. Kom ons kyk. Hy sê, deur die geloof verstaan ons dat die wêreld deur die woord van God toeberei is. Vers 14. Deur die geloof het Abel 'n beter offer aan God gebring as Kain. Waardoor hy getuienis ontvang het dat hy regverdig was, omdat God oor sy gawe getuienis gegee het, en deur dieselfde geloof spreek hy nou nog. Nou, deur die geloof, why did Abel give a different sacrifice than Cain? Heb jy enige thought on that? Well, I got the revelation this morning. Abel really believed that the sacrifice is going to God. That's why he did the super sacrifice. Cain wondered if God really accepts the sacrifice. It might be a waste of time and effort. So if you really believe when you die, that you're tithing into the kingdom of God, you tithe in a different way, or you sow in a different way. You donate time and energy. Sometimes it's not just money, it's time and energy that you put into something that is real and that you believe in. Then you get a different group, they actually wonder if it's true. So the tithe, the sacrifice, the energy, the prayer that's put into something is like a half-hearted energy. So the one believed more than the other. Abel believed thoroughly that he's bringing a gift to God. Now if you pray Rabadabda, thankful in grab. Here, mark of breath, dankbaar for me, if that of course, yes. You have the food must taste, that you have to pray that the Lord will have to make you thankful, grateful for the food. You see what you pray? That is a kind gebed. Say, Lord, how blessed is this food I'm going to eat today. Hallelujah. I am so glad that you provided for me and my family. Lord, may this food strengthen me to glorify your kingdom. Now that's a proper sacrifice of faith. Eh? Here I mark my breath, thank God for seeing the hand of what it's for bread. It's a bore with that prayer, it's not funny anymore. Come on, let's bring a prayer sacrifice of passion to the Lord, even if it's saying grace. Amen. Hy sê dan verder hierso, deur die geloof het Henog, is Henog weggeneem om die dood nie te sien. En hy is nie gevind nie, omdat God hom weggeneem het. Want voor sy wegneming het hy getuienis ontvang dat hy God behaag het. He lived a life that pleased God. En sonder geloof is onmoontlik om God te behaag. Want hy wat tot God gaan, moet glo dat hy 'n beloner is van die wat hom soek. But without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God believes that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. Mense, ach, bid vir my vir die kop seer. Ok, bid ek vir jou, Here, mag die kop seer. Ach, broers, beter. You know? If I ask you to pray for me, I believe that God can work a miracle for you. I believe you are a child of God. I believe with the anointing of God. I believe in the Word of God. The Word of God says if somebody is sick, it doesn't say God will send an angel to speak to the pastor. If the pastor doesn't know you're sick, it's not true evil at all. It doesn't say that. The pastor must know I'm sick. The fact that I'm sick in the past hasn't been here, he's not killing the Lord, the Lord would have shown him. No! He said, if you are sick, you need to phone the elder. In those days, the elder was a pastor. When you are sick, you need to phone the elder. And let the elder come lay hands on you and anoint you with oil. And God will heal you, even though you have sinned. Because if you want to believe, God only heals people that haven't sinned. You've got sad faith. Because the signs is for the unbelievers. Die tekens is vir ongelowiges, nie vir die gelowiges. En God wil die tekens en wonders werk om die ongelowiges te wys. God is almagtig en God. Amen. Right. So, if I seek the Lord through prayer, I must believe that He rewards those who diligently seek Him. Hy is 'n beloner vir die wat hom soek. Maar sonder geloof is dit onmoontlik om God te behaag. Now church without faith is a very sad church. And I love our church. Te bang om te sê die lekkerste kerk in die wêreld. People must think I'm proud. I love our church. I love this congregation. I love these people here. God vessel. Jesus. Vessel is the father van baie. Is eintlik nie moenie eintlik jou pa en seun kan wees, dit is 'n vader en seun kan. Vader en seun. Jy weet, ek hou van die vrou Wessel, en sy boys, die kom kinders, you're such a dynamic congregation, this is the bride of Christ, you're part of the body, when they come together, it's like a buzz, you don't funk your faith in the offer, you don't mom, there's something, there's life, there's joy, but with that joy, we need to start working on our faith, we need to start working on our faith, to glorify the kingdom of God. Amen. Okay. Now the problem is, when I listened to Derek Prince the other day, and he said such a beautiful thing, and I just want to open up this word. You know, now you're sitting there, and in certain aspects of your life, sekere gedeeltes van jou lewe, het jy nie geloof. Jou geloof is swak. Nou, ek lees John Wesley se dagboek. En hy sê, ek gaan met een skip. Een paar keer met een skip moes hulle geseil. Kijk, Engeland is nog baie met skepe, en dit is nie die fancy skepe van vandag nie. Hy sê, dit seil hierdie skip na die volgende plek toe, dit is al storm. Hy sê, maar is een maas of storm. Hy sê, die probleem is, die Jesus slaap nie nou in die boot nie. Dat hy kan wakker maak. Hy sê, dit is een maas of storm. Hy sê, hy vrees, he fears for his life in the storm. But on the same ship, there's a Moravians, they come from Germany. And he just hears this praising and worship and singing and joy. And he walks into this room singing, and the other Moravians are happy. There's not a sign of fear in these people. Then he goes on a few other voyages, the next thing is another storm. But he's got the fear of death, he says. They think there's a couple of Moravians. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. Yeah, but we're busy dying. Okay. And then he went to the leader of the Moravians, one of his mentors at the end. He said to him, sir, what can I do? I thought I had faith, but I don't have faith. I'm scared of dying. I'm really terrified that the ship is going to sink and I'm going to die. Before you let us go to the boat, here I can bang a boat from a corona. Here I have heart of fall, heart wall in my family. I'm terrified of diabetes. I'm terrified of this and I'm terrified of that. I'm terrified of dying. And this guy, I forgot his name, said to John Wesley, he says, my boy, or young man, you keep preaching faith. Till you get faith. You keep preaching faith till you get faith. And in the end, he kept preaching faith. And he got faith. He was one of the biggest evangelists of all times in our modern world in England. John Wesley. So, Romans 10, 17. Die geloof is deur die gehoor, en die gehoor is deur die woord van God. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of Christ. Consequently, faith results from listening. And then, International Standard Version. Consequently, faith results from listening, and listening results to the word of the Messiah. If you look at the American Standard Version, it says, so belief comes of hearing, and hearing the word of Christ. Modern King James, faith is of hearing and hearing the word of God. Now, when we hear the word of God, our faith grows. Now, as ons by mekaar kom, and we have this fellowship, and we start talking about the word of God, and it's sometimes, I don't know if you realize, that your fellowship is as if God is pouring something in you when you hear somebody say something. Then you say something that pours, and the next thing, you build on this word of God, the scriptures, and it just starts growing and opening up for you. So the fellowship of the saints is important. You need to have a chatter out there when you arrive here. You need to have a chatter out here before you run home. You need to have fellowship. You need to have coffee together. And you know what? There, that's all. You're going to build a bride. And every Sunday, I'm going to pack a fire in it. Every Sunday. And every Sunday, if you want to have fellowship with Tommy, then write in somewhere, man. Then bring your topic. Then bring it up. The fellowship is important. But then we mustn't speak about what my curious malema know here. That mustn't be the conversation. Okay. Die laat ons ons uit van morgen. The honor raised itself yet the king. We don't go there. Ek dink ons moet die droogte op delete. Jy mag nie sê droogte nie. Jy mag nie sê politiek nie. Jy mag nie sê malema nie. Jy mag nie sê plaasmoord nie. Jy mag nie sê ekonomie nie. All you do is speak and glorify Jesus. Amen. The faith comes through the hearing of the word of God. En kom, that then, you must understand, we hear the word of God through the preaching, through fellowship. But you know where faith really comes? Is when you start hearing the Holy Spirit speak to you. Jy sien jou Bybel lees, hè? Alles is waar en alles is mooi. Dan lees jy, beautiful. Nice, nice. You save it on your hard drive or your soft drive, I don't know what you call your hard, some of the hard drive, some of the soft drive, but you call it the hard drive. But next thing, God speaks to you through a specific word. And for the first time you actually hear the word speaking directly to your spirit. Now that builds faith. That's why you need to pray before you read the word of God. Say, Lord, open your word, speak to me through your word. And sometimes God will say, take this piece of scripture and forward it to somebody. Send it to somebody. I don't like sending, sometimes I get a good message, I'll forward it, but I like personal stuff. As jy sê, Pastor Shaw, die Here het vir jou hierdie woord gegee. As jy sê, Pastor Shaw, luister na Angus Bakker, ek het al daai woord 50 keer gekry. Almal sê vir die Pastor Angus Bakker in sy boodskap. You know, by the 10th time you get the message from somebody, you think, do they think I'm not saved? You know, I love Angus Bakker, the messages are good. But it gets too much after a while. Personal. Personal. Let's keep it personal. Faith comes through the hearing. The hearing by the word of God. And if you look at Acts 14 verse 8. And a certain man was sitting in Lystra without strength in his feet. Being lame from his mother's womb. Never had walked. This one heard Paul speaking. That one heard Paul speaking, and Paul looked intensely at him, and seeing that he had faith to be healed, he said in a loud voice, stand up on your feet. And he leaped and walked. You see what happened here? You came to church because your mom dragged you there, your husband dragged you there, or your wife dragged you there. Mostly it's the wife dragging husbands. Mom dragging children, well done for the women in this world that believe in Jesus. And you weren't really feeling like it. You believe Jesus is the Son of God. You believe He died on the cross. You believe everything was created through Him. But you don't really believe that He actually cares for you. And yes, it's a layman, crippled from before birth. He's just sitting there and he heard every message. But then he starts hearing the word of God. Preaching with anointing of someone that has faith in the power of God. And he listens and says that when Paul noticed that he got faith. Ek gepreek en gepreek en gepreek. Ek dink ek gaan eendag nou almal preek en almal geloof het. Kan dan lang vat. Gepreek, en hy sien, hierdie man vat het, hy takes the word, not everybody takes the word of God, not everybody believes in the word of God the way they should, not everybody's hungry for this word, but for once in this man's life, he realized that this word is true, and he felt faith, and he listened to the word with passion, and he drove the word of God, he believed the word of God, he got all excited, and he believed that when Paul said, stand up and walk, that he can stand up and walk, and he stood up and he walked. Sometimes you need to be that one encouraging somebody's faith. So between the two of you, maybe you've got 20%, I've got 80%, tomorrow you've got 80%, I've got 20%, but when we get to 100% faith, we've got a miracle happening. Then we just need a bit of that Jesus faith. Faith comes to you. Luister na die woord van God. Nie dit woord nie, luister daarna, understanding it. Faith. Says he was listening to Paul as he spoke. Now that's difficult sometimes. If I need all of you, I can't believe that you have to live on that. If I need all of you, the character sit there, I can pray, I can't rest the mark. Damn, that was a shocker for me, tell me. You know, so sometimes you've got some issues at home and you're sitting here and your mind is there. Yes, pas oor mooi gepreek, waar wat ek gepreek, dit is mooi preek, waar wat ek gepreek, is een mooi preek, waar wat ek gepreek, het my hart geraak, waar het ek gepreek, ach, dit is so mooi. Amen, I'm being there, man. I became a preacher because I cannot sit still and listen. I waste my time going to church. A battle, that's why I try to make it easy for you guys. Not always, but I try. Make it easy for you guys. Faith comes through the hearing. You have to listen to what God says. Sometimes you hear the whole message, but there's like two verses that mean something to you. And sometimes, by the way, I once preached a nice message. There was a stranger came in, and the long stop road was built there. I was like 28 years old. This guy was probably about 60 years old. And my message was about something completely different. I just mentioned something about suicide. Just like a by the way. This guy came running forward, crying, dedicating his life to the Lord. He said he's going to hang himself today. Unless God speaks to him about suicide. Isn't that wonderful? All I want to do is encourage you to be obedient. Sometimes you have to do and say funny, odd, stupid, seemingly things at stupid times. But do it. Maybe the Lord's busy saving somebody's soul in the process. Okay. Let's go back to Luke. Luke 17 verse 5. And this is something we can ask of the Lord. Vir die apostels aan die Here gesê, gee ons meer geloof. Na apostels sê die Lord, give us more faith. En die Here sê, as julle geloof gehad het soos 'n mosterdsaad, sou julle vir hierdie moerbeiboom sê, word wortel en in die see geplant, en hy sou julle gehoorsaam wees. And the Lord said, if you had the faith as a grain of mustard, you must say to this sycamore tree, be rooted and be planted in the sea, and he would obey you. Now, don't feel embarrassed to ask the Lord for faith. When is calm be not working? Say, Here, in hierdie aspect, so can I be. No, I know, if I get on my horse, and I head west into the Karoo, God's going to save us all. I know I've mobilized this congregation into a remote area, the miracles are going to happen and souls are going to be saved. But sometimes when I look at my budget, my faith is weak. You understand, not everybody has the same amount. Now luckily my wife on the other side, she said, Guru Maharaj, you're also equal. Okay. So not everybody's got the same amount of faith in the same areas. That's why our faith complements each other. Okay? And if I've got a problem with faith in a certain area, I say, Lord, help me with my faith. Help me. Don't be embarrassed. The disciples had a problem. They suffered with a lack of faith. We all have that problem. Let's speak to the Lord about our faith. And say, help me, O Lord. I do not believe that my husband will ever get saved. I do not believe that my child will be healed. That's got cancer. I do not believe. Help me with my faith. Romans 12, verse 6. Hy sê, ons besit genade gawes wat verskil volgens die genade wat aan ons gegee is. Profesie na maat van die geloof. Having gifts according to the grace that has given to us. Prophecy according to the proportion of faith. Now if you go to 1 Corinthians 14 verse 3, it says, but he who prophesies speaks to men building up, up and exhortation and comfort. And one speaking in tongues builds himself, but he prophesying builds up the congregation. Hy wat profeteer, speak to mense,
Woorde van stichting, troos en bemoediging. Hy wat in taal spreek, stig homself. Maar hy wat profeteer, stig die gemeente. Ek weet dat julle almal tale spreek, maar nog liewer dat julle profeteer. Want hy wat profeteer is groter as hy wat in taal spreek, of hy moet dit uitlê, sodat die gemeente stichting kan ontvang. Now there's something here that you have to understand. According to the measure of faith, you will be able to prophesy. It's a gift. Now if you really are more concerned about the congregation and the people out there, you will seek the Lord for faith so you can say, so says the Lord, and the Lord, and believe in what the Lord says, because you hear the voice of God. You'll have to stay with your God. Nou, as ek in die Vrystaat kom, dan denk ek ons allemaal aan die Vrystaat wat kom, daar is Soetoe man. Dan sê, oh, Isa, pak, kijk jou oor so. Molen wat dorte, hè? Dan besef ek molen werk nie. Ja, doe my la morena. Hé, hey, hoe kan jy dit? Jy kan jou vandag uit. Ina nou, is dit net nou Ina, Ina kom uit die Vrystaat. Verstaan, nou kom jy by een vreemde plek, en sê die ou vir jou, Kamu, he, Kamu, en weer gebeur, Kamu, dan kom jy by nade. So begin ons Italië. Wat tyk is, in jou gemoed ervaar jy iets. Ek het al geleer, as ek iets wil aanpak, ek voel as ons niks wil saamwerk nie, is die geest wat my praat en sê, Kakloes, stop, net die pak op van huis toe, stop die hele expeditie. En dan sê ek het werk, en as ek leer op een sekere manier as die hele my praat, ek kom weer. Nou skielik hoor ek die stem van God. Nou het ek hier een manier van God te praat, het ek ervaar. Het vat tyd, lees, het vat tyd. Sê ek, dit is die Here wat in my praat. Nou het ek al een woord geleer, of een gevoel in my hart geleer. En God so maak, is het waar. Het jy al geweet, As jy daar in die kerk sit en die hoog ontwijk, en jy begin so bewe, en jy tong begin so prewel, en lyk of jy hart wil klop, en jy voel jy van taal spreek, en jy hart nog al vinnig en klop, weet wat? Het is God wat dier die gawe van taal is, wil hy die profeteer so uitleg kan wees. Moet dit nie onderdruk nie. Spreek in die taal. Spreek in die taal en spreek so my hart op. So dat ek leg kan wees. Baie keer as God wil in die profetiese woord kom, dan begin hy dinge op. Ek druk in die snoem vast, sê bang, ek sê jy moet gaan, ek sê jy moet stop, ek sê jy moet gaan, ek sê jy moet stop. God wil die prompt in you to say something, to bring something towards the kingdom of God. Okay? So don't push that down, and you know what? I'm there for you. Het jou pastoor. Jou pastoor, daar vir jou. As jy een bykie foutie maak, Bybel sê, sien ten jy, dan sken ten jy, dan profeteer ten jy. As jy nie begin profeteer, miskien 80% is nog vlees, en 20% is van die Here, maar begin het profeteer. Ons ken nie alles nie, en soos wat jy verder lees, nou raak het beter. As die Here vir jou skrif gee, kom sê dit jy voor, ek hier vir jou. Wie wat hierdie mense sal jou nie judge nie? Would you? You judge the word, beproef alle dinge by die goeie. But let's start growing in faith. Dus we need to start prophesying the word of God. Now in a situation, many years ago, ek sien ook ten dele, ek ken ten dele, ek profeteer ten dele. En my swaar kom na my tyd vir al mutual gewerk en het een goeie werk gehad. Dat as jy goeie werk gehad, jou skuld en jou kar en alles is binne proportie. En skielik word ek geretrench. En hy bel my en hy sê, yes, son, jy is nou moeilik. Dit as jy, as jy 10.000 rand een maand kaart kan bekostig, nee, ek koop 4 of 5.000 rand een maand kaart. As jy 20.000 rand een maand huis kan bekostig, hier 5.000 rand een maand huis, dan gaan jy nie maar so rei. In elk geval, en ek bid, en ek vast, ek bid, kom my sister, en ek sê vir hom, van hoe, as ek recht hoor by die Here, het jy nie jou werk verloor.
Now the problem is, if you prophesy false, they'll see you as a false prophet. Understand? They'll never believe you ever again. No, ekse man jy nie werk verloor nie. Hy sê sorg dat jy my werk verloor. Next thing, hoe gaan dit weer? Hy het al sy tas nie gepak, hy's op fire, hy's weg. Sê die Here, sorg dat my mistyk. Did I give this person false hope? You know how embarrassing that is, giving somebody false hope. And I felt, yes. Sorry Lord for prophesying false. Sorry Lord for not hearing your voice right. And I think it was 2 or 3 days later, he phoned me crying. He said, Sean, I was busy fixing my son's bicycle, my fingers still went into the car. So did you see us this? Jy werk verloor, jy gaan jou huis verloor, jy gaan jou kar verloor, baie ouens het al hulle geld verloor, verloor hulle vrou ook. En nou het hy amper sy swanger verloor. Hy sê hy is moedeloos. Jy weet waarvan hy praat, hy was al daar, hè? Hy sê nie meer lus nie. Hy sê daar's 'n garasie by die hek. Hy maak die hek op, hier staan sy baas. Hy sê, "Fano, daar was 'n fout. Jy was toe nie geretrens nie."
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Isn't that the grace of God? We need to get a measure of faith so that we can prophesy in faith to a world out there that needs insight from God. And that's the pastor of the want ek werk nie by Grainkan penalty this. Ek werk nie by Carrara nie. Ek werk nie aan die quarry nie. Ek werk hierso. You need to get out there and make sure you have enough faith to bring a prophetic word for somebody, to build them up and give them hope in the name of Jesus. The one speaking in tongues builds himself, but he prophesies builds the church. So that brings me to tongues. You need to build yourself up in Christ. You need to build yourself up in Christ. If you build yourself up in Christ, by praying in tongues to the Holy Spirit, to the gift of the Holy Spirit. While doing that, you'll build the kind of faith in yourself so you can prophesy to the world out there that needs it, prophesy to the congregation. There is baie controversy with tale of nie tale, the tale of nie tale. Maar as jy vandag vir jouself sê, Here, ek het nodig om myself op te bou. I need to build my faith. I need to get this gift of tongues. I need the gift of faith. Lord, help me to get to that point where I can build myself up in Christ so that I can edify your church, your bride. In Christ, I need that faith. En ek gaan vandag 'n uitnodiging maak. In the altar call today is for faith. Faith that you can also speak in tongues. Faith that you are baptized with the Holy Spirit. Faith that the Lord actually saved your soul. Faith for a certain kind of faith, not just to go to heaven, but to make it difficult for the enemy. A certain kind of faith. I'm going to make a call this today. Say, Lord, if you say to me, or say to the Lord this morning, Lord, I have faith, but help my unbelief. Lord, I have faith in this, but Lord, help my unbelief in that area. And you need a special kind of faith for a miracle. I want you to come forward and we're going to anoint you with oil. And I want to ask somebody to come pray for me for a special kind of faith as well. Then my you have my bid vandag. You have my bid vandag. Een speciale type geloof. Dat ons God se koninkryk kan verder gaan. Want die help die kerk en die pastoor bly achter me. En ek glo vandag dat in jou gebed dat 'n lewe verander. Amen. Kom, ons maak ons